awesomeness of our God. The awesomeness of our God. Who looked out and saw you and me and said, I want you to be my representative. I want you. I'm going to use you. I want you to allow me to use you. The scripture I wish to start out with is Philippians, first chapter and verse 6. Being confident of this very thing, that he has begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. He saw our degradations, saw our need, saw our helplessness. Apostle Paul picked up through the inspiration of the Holy Ghost, I'm confident in what God has started. I feel that he will perform it.
Yes,
he will continue to perform it. Perform it until the end, until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Scripture talks about the early church and how that those few people turned the world upside down. They were focused. They were committed. They knew God was able. When they were threatened, they would not allow it to impede their progress. They went into a prayer meeting, and when they prayed, the place was shaken. They were rebaptized. They were re-anointed. Glory to God. He is saying the more trials, the more I'll anoint you. The more I will prepare you for greater service. To the extent that they were able to say, after having been beaten, that they rejoice at the opportunity to suffer for his name. The awesomeness of our God is just super.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Let me get some tape and tape it on.
Amen.
But God is a God that is at work now.
Yes.
He does not wait for another time. He's doing it now.
Yes.
You may sit there and you may not connect with the fact that he is doing this. But he is.
Yes, yes.
But it will be more so if I understood that he is at work now bringing me to where he has purposed me to go. Being confidence of this very thing, that he which has begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Performing it presently, performing it presently, bringing us presently, carrying out activities that causes one without awareness all the time. He is doing it because he promised to do it. He does not want you to feel that I'm depending on you to do it. But he simply wanted us to look to him who is the alpha finisher of our faith. He wants us to trust him enough to believe that he never leaves us. And Jesus has never hung around just to hang around. When he come around to do something. Tell him things. It's in your mind. If I can believe that he is. He is a rewarder. If I can believe that he is working. He'll bring it to pass. If I become satisfied with my present status, then I have no need for the greater I am. He can take me further than I can imagine. I can't even think the thoughts that he thinks of me. Still, hallelujah. He loved me beyond my imagination. Yes. Tell him thank you, hallelujah. Yes. He wants me to couple with him. Yes. Cup your hands and tell him thank you, hallelujah. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. He does not want us to enjoy the blessings of which he has purpose and plan for his children. The Gospel of St. John, the 16th chapter, says, nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. Glory to God. He didn't send the Comforter for us to go on vacations. You see, you don't have to travel to go on vacation. You can just lay down. But the Comforter is to take you through the tough times. Take you through the times when the enemy is trying to arouse you, frustrate you, trying to discourage you. Right in the midst of it all, you find comfort. What a blessing, hallelujah. And when he comes, he will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. And verse 12 said that I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. God will start dealing with your mind. So you can see and you can understand his purpose in your life. What he is all about. Why he saw you in your blood and said, live. He is at work now. The 20th verse of Ephesians 3. The Bible says, now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly, rather, exceeding and abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh, not will work, that worketh in you. I believe when the Lord spoke these words, it's almost like Abraham, before he even had a son, that the Lord had declared that he be the father of many nations. Accomplishments will be brought to bear when we have faith and trust God. God will achieve things in our lives of which we cannot imagine. He wants us to believe and trust him. Don't let me homestead here. Glory to God. I'm being affected too much by what's happening on the outside. When he has told me that, I have overcome them. Because greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. I got more victory than I know what to do. Yeah, all these things. You are more than a power. Through him that love. Thank you for your love, Jesus. Clap your hands and tell me to. Glory to God, the power of God's love. I said the power of God's love. Hallelujah. Broke through against the enemy. Hallelujah. And what the enemy tried to do, the Lord turned it all around. God can change things, can't he? He said, if you want somebody to believe him, if I can only believe him, he said, you shall see the glory of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Mary was concerned. He said, Lord, if you had been there, if you had been there, but do you know the Lord can be there without being visible? All the time. Yes. Hallelujah. They wouldn't have been able to handle it as well as it did if he wasn't there all the time. Sometimes we just need to see a physical, something that is tangible. But God wants us to have enough faith that we don't have to see it, but we know it. Tell him thank you anyhow. Don't leave me here, Lord. I'm being bothered by this, that, and the other. And if people don't love me, I want to love them anyhow. Hallelujah. When they cast me down, call my name, make me look bad. I want to be good anyhow. You're the only one who can do this song. And while you're doing it, I want to give you some praise. While they're casting me down, help me to lift them up. I know why you chose me, so I can bless somebody. But Lord, I want you to fix me. I want you to do in me what you promised me. If you do it, Lord, if you do it, Lord, I'll put my arms around you. Somebody who don't like me, I'll love them until they like me. I'm going to fix you good. I'm going to fix you good. How many of you is going to fix you good? Glory to God! The Bible declared that when the world was without form and void, Spirit of the Lord, ooh, upon the face of the deep, said, let there be, and so it was. If the Lord would do that on the water, what about his shoes? Whatever is wrong in your life, whatever needs straightening up a little bit, God can do it. I said, God can do it. Not only can, but he is doing it. He's working on you right now. He's working on me right now. What it does for you. And sometimes, just because somebody bothered me, I think that's all that's in them. But there's some good in everybody. But it takes a God consciousness and a God awareness to help bring it out. Only God can bring out difficulty in you. Everybody ought to look like angels to you. When I think about this book and how it did me, I can actually thank you, Jesus. But love is what God started this whole thing about. It was because of his love. It was because of his care for his creation. And so he picked you out. Someone has this phrase about picked out to be picked on. But he has selected and chosen you. Not for you to be exalted above another, but to be there for another.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Some of us wouldn't be able to help nobody. Yeah, we don't ask the Lord to move me.
Yeah.
I've been here long enough.
Yes.
Oh. I want another address.
Yeah.
I want another address.
Yeah.
You see that thing?
Yeah.
I had big ears. But that ear ain't rolling on. Yes, Lord. My son, my grandson was bragging on me. And he came in the office and I had already put it on. So it's all about God's love for us. He embraces us, he holds us, he keeps us. It was left up to us, we'll put him out and don't come back. But it's not left up. He is in charge.
Yeah.
Ooh, Lord. I'm glad. The loving, caring God wants me to be like him. I know I didn't deserve it. He gave it anyhow. I want to see the hands of those who deserve it. You must believe what I say. I said, hallelujah. Jesus wants to grow in grace and in knowledge. Therefore, he is performing what he started. And when God starts something, he finishes it. And he is at work at this moment. Don't cast him aside. And don't act like you belong to him. Stop showing out with the Lord. The Bible says that he will not strive which was always trying to get you to see me and what I'm trying to do, and you so busy doing your thing. Ephesians, the third chapter, starting a little bit higher in that chapter, and I want to make mention of the fact that when the Lord gave us that 20th verse and talked about the God that is able to do what we are just about to read now. If you let me, I'll do it. If you let me, I'll do it. So he says here that he would grant you according to the riches of his glory. to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man. That Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith. That you being rooted and grounded in love may be able to comprehend all with all the saints. What is the breadth, the length, the depth, and the height. And to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that you might be filled with all the fullness of God. All the fullness of God. Somebody help me say, all the fullness of God. Now you know you can't do that. But God is able to do exceeding and abundantly above all you can ask or think. I know right now this is out there. But the God you serve, he's able. I said he's able. Stop doubting the God who picked you up off of the streets. Glory to God. Who folks had thrown you out. They said you'll never make it. Especially behind what you did. But it doesn't matter what you did. God is able to do exceed and abundantly. Society does.
Amen.
But God's people don't.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Because he can do anything he wants to do. And he doesn't have to have a council meeting to do it. The sovereign God sent Moses down to Pharaoh. Tell him, let my people come. Yeah. God's talking in your behalf right now. We need to pray for wisdom.
Yes.
we need to pray for revelation. And we need to pray for full enlightenment of the truth. Because only the truth can free you. And the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. Something about his investment in you. And you need to know how important you are to him. Because he doesn't go out picking up something that he couldn't make something out of. You're talking about an investor. He doesn't buy no ground that can't produce. He said, you may not be nothing. I'm reminded of a missing loss. He picked up the worst looking house seemed like on the street. It looked like it was the street cheapest one.
All right.
Because he didn't have much money. In a little while, he turned it around. He reminded me of the Lord so much when he picked up me down there in the trash can.
All right.
Yeah. As the folks would say, but he gonna be just like the rest of them. But Jesus. Started something in me. Thank you, Jesus. Everybody who's picked up, I want to see your hand. Let me see your hand. Included in the breath the length, the depth, the height, is submerged in the immensity of the love of God, which comprehends all that is above, below, past, present, and future. It encompasses the universe and time and eternity. It reaches the depths of sin and infamy to the height of the infinite divinity. It passes all knowledge and wisdom, the God that we serve. He wants the best for us. Shout hallelujah. God's gift to man, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth shall not perish, but have everlasting life. All God wants is somebody to believe. I can do whatever in your life. Stop homesteading where you are. Look to the God who owns the world. Cattle upon a thousand hills belong to God. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and they that dwell therein. We all belong to God. If God's word don't excite you, I don't care how the drums beat on the dance floor. You don't have much.
Amen.
If the word of God don't excite you, you're dead. Plucked up by the wind. God's word is love to you and love to me. God's word. Give God some praise. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of your Son, we thank you for your love. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for picking us out, seeing us in our degradation, sins. You started the work in us of which you shall perform even till the end. No demon is going to be able to stop what you started. We thank you, Lord, for selecting us to serve you, for selecting us to reach souls for you. Help us to be a soul reacher. Please, Lord. Please, Lord. We don't know one can come to you except to be drawn. So, Lord, we ask that you would draw somebody through the life we live, through the blessings you give to us to serve the house of God. Thank you for these, your people, your children. Keep them strong. Keep them looking to you. And we'll give you all the praise and all of the glory. Thank you for working in us right now. Though we may not always be conscious of it, but keep on working in us. We want to be better. We want to be all you died for us to be. We knew it, Lord, we'll give you all the praise and all of the glory in that matchless name, Lord Jesus Christ, and so be it, in Jesus' name. And until next time, the Lord. richly bless you is my prayer.